Speak Student.
Graphing linear inequalities on a coordinate plane, a la Shmoop. Carson and Peter are roommates in a college dorm. It's their first day of school at SIT, Shmoop Institute of Technology, and they need to decide who gets which side of their dorm room. One side of the room has a nice windowsill and a nightstand, while the other side has a huge blank wall to hang up all those high school prom pictures and posters of One Direction. Their personalities fit really well together, as do their slovenly habits, as you can tell.
It's like we're mess twins.
One problem is, they both want the blank wall side of the room. Being the problem solvers they are, they decide to create a math problem out of their dilemma. They first divide the room with the equation y equals 2x minus 1. Then they write 6 pairs of coordinates on pieces of paper and put them in a hat. 3 coordinates are on one side of the line and 3 coordinates are on the other. If Carson chooses the pair of coordinates such that y is greater than 2x minus 1, then he can get the coveted wall side. Peter shakes the hat and Carson pulls out a minus 1, 0. Now they just have to figure out if he chose a point that satisfies y greater than 2x minus 1. Let's start by graphing the line. Y equals 2x minus 1. The equation is in slope-intercept form, so we can plot minus 1 on the y-axis. The slope of the line is 2. We know that slope is rise over run, so we can rise 2 units on the y-axis and run over 1 unit to the right. The inequality is only greater than and does not include greater than or equal to, so that means we draw a dotted line, not a solid line. Now let's check to see if minus 1, 0 fits the requirement. We can substitute x equals minus 1 into the equation to get 2 times negative 1 minus 1, which equals negative 3. Is the given y value of 0 greater than minus 3? Yes, success. And because Carson feels like it, he decides to shade in his side of the room to complete the graph. Good thing they don't have to worry about getting that security deposit back.
Woo!